Hello, good morning friends. I hope you are following the thermodynamic video lecture thoroughly. Here today we are going to discuss one of the JEE advanced problem which is given in 2021. The problem is here, an ideal gas undergoes a 4-step cycle as shown in the PV diagram below. During the cycle, heat is absorbed by the gas in steps 1 and 2, steps 1 and 3, steps 1 and 4, and steps 2 and 4. This is the problem. This problem is based on the two types of content. The concept of first content is we need to know the gas laws. In the especially the gas laws are Charles law and Gay-Lussac law. So we are recalling the gas laws, that is the Charles law and Gay-Lussac law. The Charles law is telling that at constant pressure the volume of the gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature. This is the law when the P is equal to constant. One more time recalling his, the volume of the gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature. This law can be written as like this opposite manner. The absolute temperature of the gas is directly proportional to its volume. What does that mean? So it is telling that if the volume is increases, then absolute temperature of the gas also will increases. Then this volume is decreases, its absolute temperature will also be decreases. This is that concept is telling that. Then one more law is there, that is the Gay-Lussac law. What that Gay-Lussac law is telling that, so at constant volume is constant, the pressure of gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature. So we can remodify this law. The temperature of the absolute temperature of the gas is directly proportional to its pressure. What does it mean? In the same above manner, we can write that if the pressure is increases, the absolute temperature will also be increases. If the pressure is decreases, its absolute temperature will also be decreases. This is the law will telling that. So we need to recall one more concept. That is the concept is what is the relation between the internal energy of the system and its absolute temperature. So we have the formula. It is a specific heat of volume at specific heat capacity at constant volume. So with help of that formula, so the change in internal energy is equal to nCV delta T is there. This formula can be written as here nRF by 2 into delta T. This formula also we have. So here is the molar specific heat capacity at constant volume. Here is the F is the degree of freedom. R is equal to ideal gas constant. So n is the number of moles. Now this formula I am getting some of the conclusions. Then the change in internal energy is directly proportional to its temperature. What does it mean? So if the temperature rises, the internal energy will also increases. If the temperature decreases, the internal energy will also be decreases. This is the relation we are getting. So that means if you know this concept, we are well enough to solve the problem. Let me recall the problem. Here they are giving one of the diagram. So in which process, this is the process 1, this is the process 2, this is the process 3, this is the process 4. In which process the system is taking the energy to into the system, that is the question. So let me solve the problem with help of the content. So I am redrawing the diagram. Here is the volume, here is the pressure, this is the first diagram. Now let me check this one, what happened about this first process. It is the process first. So will you please look on this one. If the process is a straight line, that means the pressure is constant throughout the process, that means the volume is increasing. So the volume, initial volume somewhat, and it is going to the another volume, somewhat higher the volume, that means the pressure volume is increasing. Now at constant pressure, the volume is directly proportional to its absolute temperature. So at constant pressure, volume is directly proportional to its temperature. That means volume is increases, the temperature will also increases. From this equation, the internal energy, change in internal energy will also be is directly proportional to absolute temperature. That means as the volume is increasing, internal energy also increases. So the temperature, the volume is increases, temperature increases, internal energy also increases. That is, the internal energy is the positive. So from the diagram, du is equal to a positive term. A positive term we are getting. Now let me go to the what is the work done on this one. Is it at constant pressure we can use what is the work done formula? Work done is equal to integral of P dV. This is the formula. So at constant pressure P into integral of dV. So as the volume is increases, this value we will get a positive term because of integral of dV is equal to that is equal to P into V final value minus V initial value. This is the V initial value. This is equal to V final value. So V final value is larger than the is compared to the V initial value. That means this value we are getting positive. Positive value into positive value we are getting the positive value. That means from this one, so apply the first law of thermodynamic, dQ is equal to dU plus dW. So that is the formula. dQ is a positive term, dU also is a positive term, then totally the total system is a positive term. According to the sign convention, what does it mean by positive of dQ? The amount of heat is supplied to the system. That means in process 1, the heat is absorbing by the system. So in this process heat is a positive Q. That means a positive plus 1. So in step 1 is heat is absorbing. So if you eliminate the any option, but they are giving in the 3 options they are provided the steps 1 heat is absorbing in 3 options. We cannot eliminate because of we can with help of the only one so one condition we cannot eliminate because of we need to know 3 and 4 also. So that means, so let me go to the another process, second process we are moving. So second process what they are giving. So the second process is providing like this in the graph. In the previous one we did this one, the second process is like this. So will you please concentrate it? What is this one? At constant volume, pressure of the gas is decreasing. It is the decreasing pressure graph. So in this concept, so volume is constant. Which law we can apply? So we can apply the Gay-Lussac law. So that means the pressure of the gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature. In our condition, so the pressure is decreasing, then the temperature will also be decreases. So with help of the temperature is decreasing, the change in internal energy is directly proportional to change in temperature. Then in our condition, the temperature is decreasing, the internal energy also will also be decreases. That means the internal energy is a negative term. Internal energy is a negative term. Now what is the work done by the system? So work done by the gas or work done by the system is equal to, so the work done W is equal to integral of PdV. But here the pressure is decreasing, but volume is at constant. Pressure is decreasing, volume is constant. So we have the one more formula, P into dV formula is there. dW is equal to, sorry. So let me write this formula, one more formula, dW is equal to into P into dV is there. But in this term, dV is at constant volume. So the system is doing, the process is performing at constant volume, dV is equal to 0. 0 into some value is always 0. This is equal to 0. Then apply the first law of thermodynamics, dQ is equal to dU plus dW. So this value is equal to 0, dW value is equal to 0, but dU is equal to negative term. So that means a negative term we are getting. So that means the energy is ejected from the system. It is not energy is ejecting system. Then in this process Q can be written as a negative. So let me go to the third second process. The Q is a negative, is ejecting from the system. Now come to the situation of process 3. So now come to the situation of process 3. So first process we identify, it is a plus q. The second process we solve, that is a minus q. Let me go to the third process. It is going like this. It is a pressure, it is a value. Now will you please concentrate here. It is the process where the system is undergoes at constant pressure. So again we will apply the Charles law. So at constant pressure, the volume of the system is directly proportional to its absolute temperature. The temperature of the system is directly proportional to its volume. In our process, the volume is increasing. That means the volume is increasing means the temperature must be increases because of volume is decreasing. So the volume is here is the final volume is larger as initial volume is this is the VEI, this is equal to VF. So in our process, so this is the wrong way written. So in our process, the volume is decreasing. As the volume is decreasing, then temperature must be decreases. As the temperature decreases, what will happen? So as the temperature decreases, the internal energy dU is directly proportional to its change in temperature. So as the temperature decreases, the internal energy will also decrease. That is equal to negative term. So the change in internal energy is a negative term because of what is the formula? Change in internal energy, final internal energy minus initial internal energy. As the final internal energy is going to be decreases, that change in internal energy will also decreases. Let me write dU is equal to final internal energy minus initial internal energy. So internal energy is decreasing, that's why this value is going to be negative value. Now come to the situation for the work done. Work done is equal to, we have the formula P, dW is equal to P into dV. So that is equal to P into final value minus initial value. But in our process, final value is the smaller compared to the initial value. That means this value VF is smaller than VI. So this value will provide the negative term. So this negative into some positive value is equal to negative value we'll get. So by applying the Newton's first law of thermodynamics, dQ is equal to dU plus dW. That is equal to this is the negative value plus this is the negative value, two negative values, the totally we will get the negative value. What does that mean? So this implies in this process Q is a negative, that means heat is ejecting from the system. So now come to the situation. So in this process also heat is ejecting from the system, it is not observing. Now come to the, so that means a second process is wrong, third process is wrong, but fourth process must be correct. Let me check that one also, because of first one we already proved. So the C option may be correct, then we need to cross verify that one. So let me go to the fourth process. Now come to the fourth process. So this is the first process we evaluated, this is the second process we also solved, this is the third process. Now let me go to the fourth process. Now this is the volume axis, this is the pressure axis. Now will you please look on this one, this process is going on at a constant volume. Again, which formula we can take? At constant volume, pressure of the gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature. It is the Gay-Lussac law. The temperature of the system is directly proportional to the pressure. So in our process, what is happening? The pressure is increasing. See, will you please look at this one? It is the initial pressure, P initial. This is the final pressure, P final. P final is in greater than to the P initial. So P final is greater than P initial. That means the pressure is increasing. As the pressure is increasing, temperature must be increases. As the temperature increases, the internal energy of the system is directly proportional to the change in temperature. That means as the temperature increases, internal energy will also increases. Then what will happen? Then dU, the internal energy of the system, is a positive value. Then let me cross verify that. What about the dW is equal to P into dV. It is a process where it is undergoing at a constant volume, that is equal to P into final, V final value minus V initial value. This value is the constant because of V final is equal to V initial. See, this process is the system is undergoing at a constant volume. Volume is constant. Vf is equal to Vi is equal to Vf. This value is a constant. Then this value is equal to zero. Applying the new thermodynamic first law of thermodynamic, that is equal to dq is equal to du plus dw, that is equal to du. What is the du value? Du value is equal to positive value. What is the dw value? That is equal to zero. Then that is equal to dq is equal to positive value. Then what we will get? So it is the positive value, the change of heat energy of the system is equal to positive. That means Q is equal to positive. It is the heat is supplied to the system. Then and fourth process is heat is supplied to the system. So the final conclusion, is, let me go to the in which process the heat is supplying to the system. Here also there are two processes the heat is supplying to the system. So that is the process 1 and process 4. So fourth option is the correct option. So I hope you are enjoying this video lectures. I hope you are gaining some of the knowledge from the video lectures. If you are feeling that these lectures are useful for your preparation, then you can subscribe to our channel. And also if you have any doubts regarding our subject, you can post in the comment box. Then I will try to explain that one. Thank you for watching. Thank you.